What's up guys, Joker here from 48 Hours Airsoft, and today I'm going to be talking about one of my personal guns, the G&G SR-25. So I picked the SR-25 made by G&G because it's not really a common platform that you really see on an airsoft field anymore. You usually do see the M110 style, which is basically an M16 with a suppressor or just a regular standard scope on it. I like the 7.62 platform a little bit better. It sucks because the mag well are bigger, so you can't cross-compy with really anybody else, so you have to run standard mags. And I always did want to build the SR-25 platform, just because it's really different. So to go a little bit more in-depth about what I did to this gun to make it mine, I did the barrel swap, so I changed it from a 6.05 type bore to a 6.03 type bore. After that, I decided I needed a little bit more accuracy, so I changed out the bucking and the hop-up to a Prometheus purple bucking, and G&G actually does make a metal hop-up instead of the standard plastic. And it also is a rotary style, which is a lot better. I changed out the motor for an ASG high torque motor, and the gate Titan I also added in there, because I needed the faster trigger response, because this gun is only semi-automatic. So my playstyle with this rifle over really other airsoft guns that I've owned is that I was more of an aggressive DMR kind of person, and with that I used a SEMA M14, which is probably one of my favorite guns that I still have. But with this one, since I have a little bit more extra range, I could stay back with my teammate Ox and we could really just pick people off left and right. Alright, so now I'm going to go into why I set up the gun the way I did. It's not really an extensive overlook of it, but just some simple modifications that I did. I did add the PTS pistol grip here. It's a lot thinner than the standard one that came on it. It really is comfortable to hold. I added a Matrix 16 by, I believe, 40 scope on it. Yes, it is a little bit ridiculous for airsoft, but it is okay. Mostly I got it for the looks, especially with the kill flash on it. And I opted out of the bipod just to make it a little bit more lighter, because we do hike up a lot of hills when we play at GZA, and it can be a lot to hold. Once again guys, I'd just like to say thank you for tuning into the video. This is Joker signing out, and I'll see you on the field.